see you there. It's me, Justin, aka GoogleHunter, and we are on to the video I wanted to make on some games, so I'm just gonna keep going, plowing through these. In no particular order, because there is no rhyme or reason to whatever I do. I'm just gonna put it on the shelf. I don't even have fucking room anymore. I'm looking around, I got boxes of shit just sitting around. I need more shelves. I need more space. I could probably put some shelves over there. Probably what I'm gonna have to do. Yay! As you may or may not know, in one of my previous videos, wink wink, I picked up an Odyssey 2. And along that lines, I had to buy some games. So, thankfully, someone at the retro store decided they didn't need their boxed Odyssey 2 games, which, rightfully, you don't see these too often, so I just decided I'd pick them up. Even though I really don't plan on playing Odyssey 2, it's just nice to have games in the collection. So anyways, we got Showdown in 2100 AD. Check that out. It's like a Western, I guess. But like the box art is so cool. It's like when it's got like a you know, he's got like a cybernetic arm. And you open it up and it's like a little blurb. I mean, they just made box art awesome. It was like the shit back in the day. Baseball. It looks like it's never, well, it's obviously been open, but it's sealed now, so I can't open it. But it's baseball, so who the fuck cares? UFO! Otherwise known as UFO. Again, I mean, just check out these cartridges. They remind me so much of, like, the Jaguar with the handle. It's like you're making an effort to go... Blockout Breakdown. Boop! Usually these cartridges had about two games. Like, this one has Blockout, Breakdown. Looks like you're... typical, what you call it, Breakout. Except they call it Blockout for some fucking reason. Computer Golf. Nothing comes with putt-putt. No, just Computer Golf. The Quest for the Rings. I'm not gonna open it. It was missing a couple of things. It still is missing a couple of tokens. But I think you could still play it. But what it was is... it would come with, like... this nice fold-out board, and you had this overlay. Yeah, these overlays you'd put on the actual Odyssey 2 to correspond, I think, to the buttons. Like, there's a reset button there. So you had those, and it came with, like, tokens. You put all the tokens down. Just came with, like, a nice-ass manual. I mean, just check that out. I mean, the artwork. It's just crazy. I mean, that was like the shit. Back in the day, man, you got your fucking Odyssey, you need all that shit. You know? And they don't make them like that anymore, so I thought that was pretty cool. It was, I mean, they're cheap, dirt ass. I didn't pay more than, I think, 50 bucks for the system, and I think the most I spent was like 10 bucks for one of the games. Most of them were like 5 bucks. Got some Wii games. SSX Blur for 89 cents. The SSX used to be good, not so much anymore, I don't think. Mushroom Men, because, you know, Metal Jesus talks about it. It's one of those hidden gems. Soul Calibur Legends, which is kind of, I think, like Hyrule Warriors, you know, the Dynasty Warriors-ish type stuff, so. Excite Truck, I've heard mixed stuff about this. It's from the Excite series, but this is the truck spray. It just looks funny, because you play as, like, a demon... or a guy who has, like, a devil and an angel, and, like, the devil can, like, vomit, and you're supposed to, like, color shit, and so it's kind of funny. It's by Tecmo. I don't know. I couldn't tell you anything about it. Kirby's Return to Dreamland. It just does not go down in value. For some reason, even on eBay, it's still, like, 40, 50 bucks for it, so I said, fuck it. Had some extra money, traded some stuff in, so I picked it up. Will I ever play it? I don't know. Turn out the lights, motherfucker, and I glow. To the extreme, I wreck a mic like a vandal. I light up a stage, I wax a chump like a candle. Wah, wah, wah. I picked up an amiibo. Got me the Mario Man. I don't know why I didn't have this game. I wanted this game for, well, I had this game back in the day, so when I found it on Amazon for $10, I fucking jumped on it. Probably could have gotten this, well, the guy could have sold it for more, but whatever. It's Capcom Saturday Night Slam Masters. This is an excellent wrestling game, but it's got Mike Hagar from Final Fight, I think before he became mayor of Metro City. It's just fun. It's arcadey. It had, it was an arcade game. And they came out with a sequel. I think it's called, like, Ring of Destruction 2. I think it only ever came out in the arcades. I don't think it ever made a way to the home console. Pokemon! They got Pokemon Yellow, Pikachu Edition, and Pokemon Silver. Unfortunately, this one saves, this one does not, so I had to order a battery and I'll have to replace it. Poke. Found some stuff at the Goodwills. Found a sealed copy of Darkness 2, limited edition. $5, but I had the first one. Never played through all of it. The Bible game. I just picked it up because I think I have it on the PS2, but I didn't have it on the Xbox. And I don't know. It's a weird game, but you don't come across it that much. I was excited to find this. Inuyasha Feudal Combat for the PlayStation 2. It's a fighting game by Bandai. And I have one for the PlayStation 1, and there was not that many Inuyasha games that came out. So when I saw that at the thrift store for $4, and it was complete and in good condition, I picked it up. Bleach, it's a fighting game, did not have it, paid $5 for it. A whopping $2 for Astro Boy, it's probably not very good, and I think I may already have it, but who knows. Then I found a stack of really good games at, where the fuck did I find this? Oh, it was at a Goodwill. So on the GameCube, I found a copy of Pikmin 2, which does not have the manual, unfortunately. Sonic Adventure 2 Battle, complete. Star Wars Rogue Leader, Rogue Squadron 2, complete. Baldur's Gate Dark Alliance, complete. I found a movie of Dante's Inferno. I'm a sucker for anime and manga, so whenever I see that, pick it up. And then the God of War collection for the PlayStation 3. Did not have this. Had the PSP one. And I guess I have Ascension too. I've never played it, but. And last but not least, I got some DS and Game Boy Advance games that I just picked up today, actually. I got a copy of Game & Watch Gallery 4. These are all the Game & Watch games. I think this is the last one I needed. I think there was only 4 ever released. Compilations, they all have the Game & Watch games. Yu-Gi-Oh! The Sacred Cards. I used to play the Yu-Gi-Oh! Games on the Game Boy Advance. So, I'm a sucker for them. Plus, they were half price. They're only $2 a piece. Yu-Gi-Oh! World Championship Tournament 2004. Madden 08. Cover my face, motherfucker. And last but not least, Animal Crossing Wild World. So, those are all half price, so they were $2 a piece. That's gonna do it, everybody. Thank you for tuning in for hopefully a quick video on the last remnants. I have one more video out right after this we're gonna shoot, so stay tuned for that. But as always, fuck you goddamn midgets.
Hello and goodbye, January. This month, a video a week, I actually did it. Surprised I was able to do it, but everything came out on time and I think it went well overall. So thank you very much for your feedback. I've been looking at all of it, logging it, trying to find out trends, things that people like, things that people don't like, and suggestions for other things to do in the future. It was a pilot, so of course it's gonna be a little rough around the edges.